On May 17, 1900, the children's novel, The Wonderful Wizard of Oz, was published to a wide approval from its audience. As the years have passed, we still can recall those colorful cast of characters, as their impact on our childhood was pretty great. Even if you have never read the book or knew about the 1902 Broadway musical adaptation, I'm sure the vast majority of you have seen the 1939 musical adaptation starring Judy Garland. Dorothy has found herself in the Land of Oz, and she encounters some of the most strangest characters that we could see. A scarecrow who wants a brain, a tin man who desires a heart, and a cowardly lion who simply wants courage. Now they discovered that to receive what is needed, they had to seek out the Wizard of Oz. Now, could we as Christians see a parallel between some of these famous characters? Could we, in fact, use these very fictional figures to teach another generation about the promises found in Scripture? Now, the scarecrow who wanted a brain reminds us that we, too, need to have a new mind in Christ. The Apostle Paul declares in Romans 12:2, "Do not be conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewal of your mind, that by the testing you may discern what is the will of God. That is good and acceptable and perfect." When we come into a relationship with Christ, He gives us a new mind. What dwells in our thought life moves from our selfless ambition and begins to move to what is best for those around us. It is also important to have our minds renewed, because often Satan will attack your thought life. Satan will try to bring back your past and make you think that you are not good enough to be saved. You need to remember, friends, is that it is by God's grace and not our good deeds that we have salvation. Now, the rusty tin man would only be complete with a heart. Ezekiel chapter 36, verse 26 says, "I will give you a new heart and put a new spirit in you. I will remove from your heart of stone and give you a heart of flesh." Now, when we think about a person's heart, we often have the idea about what they're passionate about. Now, I promise it doesn't take long to discover what a person has passion for. A grandparent will pull out photos from their wallet to show off their adorable grandchildren. A sports fanatic can talk for hours about the recent ball game and list the stats of their favorite player. If someone were to view your computer's search history, now would they learn that you have a passion for gossip or the gospel? If an individual were to view your checkbook, would they discover that you spend more money on movies than on missions? Believers in Christ can brag on their grandchildren, enjoy watching a basketball game, and even go to the movies. However, if we ever put any of these things of the world above Christ, then we lack a true heart of passion for our Savior. Now, finally, we come to the cowardly lion. He needed what all believers need in this world, and that is courage. Deuteronomy 31 verse 6 says, "Be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid or terrified because of them, for the Lord your God goes with you. He will never leave you nor forsake you." Courage is not the absence of fear. It is acting in spite of your fear. Nobody knows this better than Christians who defend their faith in places where Christianity isn't the leading religion and are mistreated for their beliefs. These people know fear, but they move forward nevertheless. They don't allow their fear to paralyze them. They confront anxiety, discomfort, perceived danger, doubt, and intimidation head on, because they know that they are called to do this. Never forget that with God's protection and guidance, we have nothing to fear and can conquer anything that is before us. Now, I encourage you today to remember that God is the giver of good gifts and can supply what you spiritually need. Reverend Billy Graham once proclaimed, "We can be certain that God will give us strength and resources we need to live through any situation in life that He ordains." You are not alone on this spiritual journey, friends, and God will not abandon you in your time of need. This is Pastor Ken Smith, thanking you for listening to Transforming Lives.